L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love, is all that I can give.
We are here today to celebrate the union of Kiana Roshan and Emmanuel Ovale. It's a privilege to be here as we celebrate the union of these two people. My name is Danny Slavich. I'll be officiating the wedding today. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, thank you for this sacred moment. Thank you for the privilege of witnessing this special day. I just thank you for bringing so many people who have poured into the life of this couple and for what you've done in their story. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. I got a call at about 10 a.m. this morning from a good friend of mine, Pastor Derek Allen. And he was in the security line of the Atlanta airport and said he'd missed his flight and there was a wedding ceremony for a very special couple, and he wanted to know if I would be able to be a part of this special day, and I said I'd love to. It's a privilege to be here. It's awesome to see how God plans moments before we could have ever planned them ourselves. Before sin entered the world in Genesis chapter 3, and the need for salvation came through sin, God planned a picture of salvation before it was even needed. In Genesis 2, God planned the institution of marriage to portray the redemption of sinners through his son, Jesus Christ. God told the story of salvation before salvation was needed. He's sovereign, and he knew this moment long before any of us knew this moment. And he knew your story long before you knew your story. And he's writing your story. He's created your marriage. He's created your life together. As he created that picture of the gospel in marriage, long before it was even needed. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 18, it says, "It's not good for a man to be alone, and I will make a helper fit for him." Emmanuel, God didn't design you to be alone. As men, we can tend to be independent and self-sufficient. But you're not enough by yourself. You need Jesus, and you need your bride. He has designed her for you. Kiana, the same goes for you. God designed Emmanuel for you, and you for him. When it says the wife is the man's helper, it's not speaking of subservience, but completeness. The Bible says God is the helper of his people. He completes them and gives them what they need. It's been said that God formed the man, the woman, out of the man's rib. Not from his head to rule over him, not from his foot to be trampled by him, but from his side to accompany him, to be next to him. That's his calling for both of you. And there are differences between you. And God has designed those differences like sandpaper to smooth you into the image of Christ. Because as much as God has designed you to complete each other, you can't ultimately complete each other. Only Christ can do that. Only Christ can offer you the perfect completion of your identity and your life and your marriage and your relationship. Very often in weddings, they'll have a rehearsal the night before. And this moment, in a very real sense, is a dress rehearsal for the great wedding of Christ and his bride, the church. This moment is about you, but more ultimately, it's about him. It's about the ultimate reality and the ultimate love and the ultimate companionship of Christ and his bride. Neither one of you was designed to carry the weight of the other person's soul. As much as you need each other and complete each other, you will crush each other if you place your entire identity in the other person and in your relationship. You have to find your identity and your foundation in Christ. And when you fail, to give grace and forgiveness. Don't ever for a moment wonder if you've made a mistake. Because God is here right now. And when you turn around to walk back down the aisle, you'll see all of these witnesses who are here to tell you that this moment was ordained by God, that he has designed you for this moment. And he has designed each of you in ways you don't even realize yet for the other person. God is here and he will hold your relationship together. And one day, as God brings all things to completion and makes all things new, we see there's hope, and God delights in marriage, and he delights in your marriage, and you can trust him with your marriage. And as you go into the moments ahead of you and the months ahead of you and the days and the weeks and the years, remember that as you covenant together, you are mirroring the covenant love that God has for his people. And just like he won't give up on his people, he will not ever give up on you. At this time, we're going to symbolize that covenant love by the exchange of vows and rings. And so, Emmanuel, do you take Kiana to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of marriage, to love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Kiana, do you take Emmanuel to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's command in the holy estate of marriage, to submit to him, love in him, and honor him, to keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, to keep yourself only for him, so long as you both shall live.
I do.
And now I believe you have some vows that you've written for each other.
Kiana, Chelsea, Roshan. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate, were some of Jesus' words in Matthew 19:6. I am amazed at how God put two broken and imperfect people together for his glory. He can take something or someone that's broken and mold it into the most beautiful art that can exist. You are my beautiful brown skin, love of my life. I remember when I first had feelings for you. I tried to deny it because you were 8 years or are 8 years younger than I, and we lived about 18 hours away from each other. I thank God we continued, not knowing I would be writing my vows last night. When I told you that if we wanted something serious, you need to speak to your parents about me first. Fast forward over 2 years and look at where we are now. We are being united as one in front of God and all the witnesses here. In this 2+ years in a relationship, we had a bumpy ride and a lot of ups and downs. However, all of that only matured us, molded our character, loved each other more, and consistently placed God in the center of our lives and relationship. We are not perfect, but I hope our testimony in these last 2 years edified other people and couples. Babe, you know how Adam was commanded by God to cultivate the Garden of Eden with all those beautiful flowers and plants? You are my lovely and precious garden. I will forever cultivate it. I'm far from being the best fiancé and then husband, but by God's grace, I promise to consistently be the best husband I can be because I know I will fail at times. I will look at my failures as opportunities to be better as the time goes by. One thing I made sure to do is remain sexually pure before getting married. I did it not because it's a good and rare thing to do nowadays. I did it because I honored myself. I honored you, your parents, my friends, your friends, our church family. But ultimately, I remained pure because I wanted to honor and obey God. My lover, what I'm writing isn't enough to really express how I feel, but that's okay, because my ultimate expression of love towards you will be ongoing through our journey in marriage. God is writing our love story as we live out the gospel as a married couple. Problems will come, but so will the blessings. The blessings of God are much greater and weightier than anything in the world. Sweetheart, there are so many definitions of success, but there is one definition I had that relates to you. It is this: success is when people are better off because you live. God has used you to make me live holy before him and everyone else. God has used you to make me a better person. God has used you to help me to love you. I wish I can write more on this paper, but allow me to live out what I have in my heart because it will have a longer and lasting value. Just know that I'm super ready to the 100th power to take you as my wife and to love you as Jesus loved the church. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate, were some of Jesus' words in Matthew 19:6.
Blew me out of the water. Okay. Emmanuel, to say that I am speechless at the sight of you when my heart overflows with words to describe my love is an understatement. I am at home when you hold me and you calm the storms that rage within me. When I first met you 2 years ago, I immediately knew that I had a friend in you. Little did I know that God would give me a lover for a lifetime. The way you loved and forgave me has inspired me to be a better woman for God and for you. Your God-given gift of patience has withstood my fear of letting my guard down and risk losing myself. I've come to realize that I find myself loving you more when I choose to lose my need to protect my heart, and you're so worth it. Life has thrown some hard obstacles our way, from homelessness to heartbreak. We've learned some tough lessons and endured blows strong enough to pull us apart. I thank God that our love was stronger. Over time, I got so used to guys giving up on me and not waiting for me. You waited for me like Jacob waited for Rachel, just as you promised. You never gave up on me, even when I felt like giving up on everything we had. Your example of what it means to fight for love prepared and shaped me to be what I've always wanted to be, your wife. For the next 100 years, I pray that I can love and serve you the way that Jesus has done for us. My goal is to die to myself so I can build with you and glorify God with you. I remember thinking how scared I was to be with someone forever, knowing that hard times will come. If walking in the dark means walking alongside you, then I'd walk 1,000 miles as our steps tell a beautiful story of love and faithfulness. I remember right before we received blessings from my parents to date that I told you I'll go wherever you go. Even with all my fears and anxieties, I meant that. For as long as I live, I'll be with you and for you. My love for you will run deeper than any ocean. I don't mean to over-spiritualize, but I believe that your name means more than we realize. A lot of times in life, I felt so alone, even as a young Christian woman. Every time I look at you and your name flows from my lips, it is a reminder that God indeed is and has always been with me. God is with us, Emmanuel, and I am blessed to fulfill the calling of marriage with the one whom my soul loves.
Amen. I believe you have rings as a sign of your covenant and love for each other. Emmanuel, take the ring and place it on the fourth finger of Kiana's left hand. And hold it in place as you repeat after me. Kiana, with this ring, I marry you.
Kiana, with this ring, I marry you.
And I give everything I have in the world to you.
And I give everything that I have in the world to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Take the ring and place it on the fourth finger of Emmanuel's left hand. And hold it as you repeat after me. Emmanuel, with this ring, I marry you.
Emmanuel, with this ring, I marry you.
And I give everything I have in the world to you.
And I give everything I have in the world to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Emmanuel and Kiana, by the power given to me as a minister of the gospel, I now pronounce you man and wife. Emmanuel, you may kiss your bride. Face these witnesses, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, it is my privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Emmanuel Ovale.
He's all mine.
Ready?